If you've seen my video reviews here, well, first of all, thank you. But also, you've probably noticed that I do a lot of mobile technology. It's kind of my wheelhouse. So when Bored at Work asked me to take a look at a laptop, I wasn't sure it was, you know, me. But once I learned this puppy flips into a tablet, I was all ears. I'm Adam Dowd with Bored at Work, and this is our full review of the Lenovo ThinkPad X1 Yoga. The first thing I think I should mention is that I have spent the last 5 years living the MacBook life. It wasn't really a choice, but I quickly fell in love with macOS. I have kept pace with Windows and Windows 10 through a review or two, and a secondary computer that my wife and kids use more than I do, but this is the first time that I've really used a Windows 2-in-1, and I gotta say, Microsoft is doing some smart things here. I'm not gonna do a deep dive into the software, but I do need to mention some highlights. The transition from Windows laptop mode to tablet mode makes a lot of sense, and Windows 10 is great on a tablet. Windows Snap, the feature that allows you to quickly position windows on one side of the screen or the other in a split screen mode, is the bomb. And finally being able to edit audio on a tablet using a pen fulfills a dream that I've had for over a decade. That's the audio for this review that I'm editing, by the way. I don't want to spend too much time on the software here. I mean, it's Windows 10, and after all, it's been out for years. But I was able to do all of my work from two different jobs, at home and on the go, just as easily in Windows as I was on macOS. But let's talk about what we're here to talk about, shall we? This is a 14-inch Full HD laptop with 360-degree hinge to turn the laptop into a tablet and back again. Under the carbon fiber chassis is an 8th generation Core i5 1.6GHz processor, 8GB of RAM, and 512GB of onboard storage. You'll also find a fingerprint sensor, a 54-watt-hour battery, and just about every port you can think of, all of this weighing in at just a hair over 3 pounds. And speaking of ports, you've got two Thunderbolt 3 USB Type-C ports, two USB 3.0 Type-1 ports, HDMI out, microphone and headphone jack, and a microSD and a microSIM slot. This laptop will happily tell you where you can shove your dongles. The fingerprint reader, in conjunction with Windows Hello, is a welcome addition and frankly something that every laptop in the world should have, and there are no exceptions to that. Now, I might be spoiled by phones, but the fingerprint reader is slow and not all that accurate. But it is better than typing a password or a PIN every time you want to log on, thank you very much. The keyboard is a 6-row Wave keyboard. Each key is slightly concave. It is spill resistant, but I'd personally suggest you not endeavor to test that yourself. The space between the keys is good, and the keys themselves have good travel, but a bit more travel than I generally like. The keyboard sports a TrackPoint mouse, which, I have to admit, I thought we as a society had moved on from. But I guess I can understand why, since compared to other trackpads in 2018, the one on this laptop is a little on the small side. I liked it, it was big enough for me, but I can understand why some people might want a bigger one, and I need to stop talking before I start sounding like my wife. One thing that Lenovo has done here, and I've asked around and checked a few other 2-in-1s that I've come across, and I think this is somewhat unique to Lenovo, but when you put this laptop into tablet mode, as you move the screen around, the keyboard on the back retracts. And believe me, that's like the best thing ever. It's such a small thing to do, and it makes so much sense. I'm gushing. Do I sound like I'm gushing? I might be gushing, but seriously, bravo, Lenovo. Some may argue that introducing yet another moving part into the design is a potential mistake, but you made me a fan. Another smart thing that Lenovo did, it built its pen into the laptop. That's right, suck it, Surface. Galaxy Note style is what we're talking about here. The pen is built into the body of the laptop and charges it at the same time. Yes, the pen does need to be charged, but Lenovo claims that 15 seconds of charging is enough for 100 minutes of use. In my time using the pen, it never discharged fully, but I'm probably not as hardcore a user as some. I did find the buttons on the pen hard to press, and the pen itself was a little too thin to press a button and use the pen, at least for my fat fingers. But if you're going to embed the pen into the laptop, it needs to be thin, I get that. And I prefer having a pen in the machine over something thicker that doesn't fit. Battery life is quite good on this laptop. I average between 6 to 8 hours of battery life with a screen at 50% brightness and a few apps like Slack open, and an inordinate number of Chrome tabs. I never felt shy about taking this laptop out without a power cable, which is pretty beefy, by the way. So let's wrap this up with a few other test notes. For added security, you have a physical camera cover switch so you can easily keep prying eyes at bay. Also, the build of a laptop is carbon fiber, but it feels plasticky, and in a world of aluminum and magnesium, it feels a little cheap. The SD and SIM card reader on the back is an unusual placement, and frankly took me about 5 minutes and a reviewer's guide to find. The laptop hinge is stiff enough so it fails the one-handed opening test, which is overrated in my opinion anyway, but it's also loose enough that it fails the bobblehead test. All that being said, this is a really nice laptop that gets a lot of things right, from ports to power to battery. But there are a few questionable choices, like seriously, a TrackPoint mouse in 2018? But overall, I thoroughly enjoyed my time with the Lenovo X1 Yoga. There is a question of price, which at $1,400 is pretty crowded territory, but for that money, given those options, I think the Yoga would be my first choice. Thanks for checking out our full review of the Lenovo ThinkPad X1 Yoga. If you like this video, give us a little thumb love down below. Don't forget to subscribe to Bored at Work for more videos like this one, and be sure to click that bell icon so we can tell you when the fresh one hits the air. As always, make sure to hit us up in the comments down below. What do you think about 2-in-1 laptops? Love them or hate them? Let us know down below. Once again, I'm Adam Dowd, Dead Technology on Twitter, reminding you to always enjoy your entertainment.